Turkish Getup is an interesting exercise. It allows us to get in some great positions. And within these positions, we can tap into skill development, but also we can dive into or tap into a lot of neurological components that work on increasing stability, and hence, which is going to enhance performance. Unfortunately, when we pair it with both load and turn it into an exercise, what we do is we just basically start burning calories because we don't have the frequency or the opportunity to really spend time in those positions. And there's nothing wrong with that. If that works for you, that's great. But if instead we deconstruct the Turkish getup, if we want those neurological adaptations, we want the skill development side of it, then we spend time in those subsets of the movement focusing on it. Part one of our deconstructed Turkish getup is the baby getup. And honestly, you don't need load. In fact, you might need some assistance with doing this, with the way that we do it. So this is going to be a little different than you would see or be trained to do a weighted Turkish getup, but there's a reason for that. We're trying to tap into some stuff. The biggest thing that we're trying to tap into here is firing up this oblique sling from shoulder across to hip. We're going to have some impact on shoulder health. We're going to have some impact on hip, but the biggest also is going to be controlling and stabilizing the core, and again, that outward impact. So here's some things that we want to pay attention to. So anytime we're in a post position, you're going to see this a lot. We want to keep this shoulder away from the ear. So when we're pushing against the ground, either here or your elbow, you want to make sure that you're not hiking up like this. So you're always going to be thinking about pushing away. You want to be tall with the head, so you're going to be extending. Even if your head's pointing toward the wall, we don't want to be hunching, crunching, reaching, anything like that. Now the key pieces while doing this lift is controlling rotation at the core, okay, or crunching. Okay, we don't want to do either of those. Now, one thing that is going to be different as I show this than a lot of people will, is a lot of people are really concerned with this non-posted foot picking up off the ground. It might pick just a little bit with the way that I'm going to show this, and that's okay. If you're using that to balance and move you, it's different. So you'll notice I'm in this down position where I was with the Turkish getup, where I'd push that weight up here, okay? Instead, I've got no weight. Now, I want to stabilize this complex and not move it. So that means no movement this way. This is a key piece for me. Now again, no rotation, no flexion, no extension. I'm gonna drive off of this heel here, boom! And you'll see, this is stable and didn't shift here. So that's different than a lot of people would do a Turkish getup, because they'd roll onto the shoulder first and then push up. This has a huge impact on getting this shoulder ability to control itself, is bam, boom, right there, okay? Now, here's the slouch, shoulder in, push it away. Here's flexion, again, tall. You're gonna see this repeated throughout a number of these drills. Now on the way down, I am going to let this shoulder break. I'm gonna go first as far as I can without it, then I'm gonna allow a little break, and this is where it gets tricky, is try to go down super slow as you possibly can, until that scap is just grazing the ground, boom, right there. That is some powerful input through the whole system. So let me show you again, post. Controlling this, it does not move, boom, okay? Tall, reach, pushing away, back, shoom. A lot of you'll find, you'll get to that close to this position, you'll just drop out. That tells you, you need to spend some time with this. Kyle's gonna show some additional ways to do this.
So just to highlight here, Chris, go ahead and pop up. Even when Chris pops up, when he does talk about the articulation of the scapula, go ahead and come down, it never hunches up here. That's really important to highlight. A lot of people are going to struggle with that move. He's talking about the scapula moving, but gliding on the rib cage. The other thing we really like to see here, you can look at your training partner or yourself and just intersect a T. this line is straight and this line is straight. It never rotates or crunches as Chris was talking about.
Think about a telephone or an electrical pole. This is the outer beam. It's not going to break.
And since we're talking about how challenging this movement can be, you may not have the strength or the neurological adaptation to hold your scapula in place. So two easy solutions, partner assisted. I'm just going to pull some weight up and then let my partner drop their body down as I take some of the body load off. Don't have a partner? No problem. You're going to loop this up.
And so that is a really valuable, a lot of people can't do this, that engagement pattern. They're strong enough, but that's when we're talking about the neurological inputs. It's not firing and working the way they want, and all of a sudden you'll see a huge impact in their lifts once they learn how to get that.
Most definitely. So we'll have this looped up, however, so put it through your fingers just so it doesn't slip out of your hands. And I'm obviously going to be the squat rack here, but I would tie this off on the top of a squat rack so you don't have a partner. Just tie this off. Chris comes up. That's going to take some of the load off. He articulates down. Once again, just taking a little bit of that body weight off, making those challenging situations a little bit easier to control.
And that is how we do the baby get up.